أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ونادى نوح ربه فقال رب إن ابني من أهلي وإن وعدك الحق وأنت أحكم الحاكمين. قال يا نوح إنه ليس من أهلك، إنه عمل غير صالح، فلا تسألني ما ليس لك به علم، إني أعظك أن تكون من الجاهلين. قال رب إني أعوذ بك أن أسألك ما ليس لي به علم، وإلا تغفر لي وترحمني أكن من الخاسرين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. صلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. الحمد لله. We are in the second part of Ramadan, the second 10 days of Ramadan. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love manifests itself in the month of Ramadan, the beginning of it is mercy. And now we are in the manifestation of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala into the stage of forgiveness. And eventually the goal of Ramadan, وَعِتْقٌ مِنَ النَّارِ. The goal of Ramadan that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will pardon us, insha'Allah ta'ala. Mercy is looking at things, subhanallah, is like somebody who's been sentenced. And mercy is lessening and reducing the sentence. Forgiveness is to take the sentence away after a trial. And pardoning, afu, is not to have a trial whatsoever. That's why at the end of the Ramadan, Sayyidah Aisha asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about a dua, and the dua, Allahumma innaka afuwan tuhibbu al-afwa fa'afu anna. The dua today that we have recited is from Hud and from verses 45 through 47, subhanallah. This is the dua of the weary. This is the dua of a person in desperation. This is a dua of the person in distress. This is the dua of a prophet, peace be upon him, to his son, in particular Prophet Nuh alayhi salam. But before we go to the dua, subhanallah, there are three consecutive chapters that we've been reading as part of our Taraweeh. You probably are now on chapter Hud, which is the chapter we are on. After it is the chapter Joseph, and before that is the chapter that talks about Jonah. And what is really interesting about those chapters, that Jonah and the chapter after that's called Hud, Hud is mentioned very little, and so is Jonah's mentioned very little. All the prophets are mentioned in these chapters, subhanallah. But nevertheless, the idea here that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to give us a message. Chapter that we're reading, that is entitled Hud, is the chapter that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, شَيَّبَتْنِي هُود وَأَخَوَاتُهَا. That this chapter brought gray hair to me. Because all these chapters talks about how the prophets, peace be upon them all, they go through trials and tribulations and the rejection from their people. But there's something in particular in Hud, subhanallah, is when the chastisement and when the harm comes from the people who are closer to you. In particular, the chapter of Hud, this particular dua, subhanallah, it is a cry for help from a father who is Noah to his son. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in this chapter that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told Noah to ask for forgiveness. And Noah subhanallah does ask for forgiveness. 45, and Noah called upon his Lord and said, O my Lord, verily my son is my family, and certainly your promise is true, and you are the most just and the most just of all judges. Allah says, this is the story of Noah's son, of course, being on a mountain and he will not get on the ship. He said, O Noah, surely he's not of your family. Verily, his work is unrighteous. So ask not of me that which you have no knowledge. Then Noah immediately repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, says, O my Lord, this is a dua, I seek refuge with you from asking you that of which I have no knowledge of. And unless you forgive me and have mercy on me, I would indeed be one of the losers. So the dua, subhanallah, Rabbi inni a'udu bika an as'alak ma laysa li bihi ilm wa illa taghfir li wa tarhamni akun min al-khasirin. This is a dua of Nuh alayhi salam. O Allah, I seek refuge in you, that I will ask you out of ignorance. And indeed, O God, forgive me and have mercy on me. We're talking about forgiveness and we're talking about mercy. This is a dua, subhanallah, and a chapter that brought gray hair to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In a sense that when your own people, your own, you know, when the trials and tribulation comes from your own tribe, your own people, your own family, subhanallah, it's harder on a person, especially that person who's calling for the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This chapter brought gray hair to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in that chapter that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was in a no man's land being rejected by his own people, his own tribe, the Prophet, peace be upon him, some people came to the Prophet, peace be upon him, wanting to help him. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was listening to those people. Although those people were ungodly people, they wanted to help the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not because they believed in his cause, but rather they have bigoted information or bigoted ideas about Quraysh. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this chapter told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتْ. Stay on the path, right? Staying on the path is very difficult, subhanallah, when your own tribe, your own people, that are very close to you, subhanallah, they're rejecting you. وَلَا تَطْغَوْا. Do not transgress the limit. Indeed, subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. Those people who say, oh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our Lord, then they are on the straight path. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمِ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. The angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come upon them. أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. Have no grief and have no worries. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ. Indeed, the Jannah is the way. So this chapter brought gray hair to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The dua is a dua of Nuh alayhi salam, of distress. And the dua is calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-ghafoor, al-raheem, the most forgiving, the most merciful. For indeed, we need to live with this name, inshallah ta'ala, for a few minutes at least. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-ghafoor, the word Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-ghafoor, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would do three things to us. Number one, as-satr fi dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would overcome our errors in this life. He will conceal our errors from others in this life. And He will conceal our sins from being public in this life and from being public in the hereafter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from the hellfire, inshallah ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven his sin, he said he used to say istighfar often. 100 times is the word that he uses. However, that means a plethora of time, plenty of time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنِّي الْغَفَّارُ لِمَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا ثُمَّ اهْتَدَى. I am al-ghaffar, I am the forgiver to the person that repent to me and believe on me and do good deeds. This is the month of Ramadan that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. This is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we repent, go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with repentance. This is the month of Ramadan that inshaAllah ta'ala we do righteous deeds. Repentance, believing in Allah and do righteous deeds will send us to guidance, subhanAllah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Atani Jibreel, Gabriel came to me and he said, O Prophet Muhammad, give the glad tiding to your ummah. And the glad tiding of the ummah that inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all sins. And the Prophet asked, even if that person steals and commit adultery, he asked that 3 times. And Gabriel said, yes. And the Prophet keep asking that question. Even Gabriel said, even if he steals and he commits adultery and even he drinks alcohol, meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have a plenty of istighfar, inshallah, a plenty of forgiveness for us. And here is something maybe I would leave you with, inshallah ta'ala, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man lazim al istighfar. Anybody who keeps saying, astaghfirullah, I seek refuge in Allah, oh Allah, forgive me. And the word astaghfirullah doesn't mean, oh Allah, forgive me. But rather than it is a call for help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the constant mistake we make. If we keep saying that, astaghfirullah, 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 ja'ala Allahu lahu min kulli dhiqin makhraja, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will find from any distressful way a way out for us, inshallah ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with ameen. Wa min kulli hammin faraja. With every distress, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will find us a way out. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will find from each grief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also will relieve all the grief from that. وَرَزَقَهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. And a bonus with that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would give us provision from places that we never thought they're necessary. We never thought they were possible. So مَنْ لَزِمَ الْإِسْتِغْفَارِ. Those people who keep saying astaghfirullah, 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 astaghfirullah. You know, or instead of saying, oh shoot, or you know, why is this happening? We keep saying astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will psychologically heal us from within. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who listen to the speech and follow the best of it, among those inshallah ta'ala who keep always making istighfar and going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance and forgiveness. Jazakumullahu khayran. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.